Isa pong documentary na ipinakita sa Public Broadcasting Service Channel o PBS ang umantig sa puso ng mga Pilipinong nakapanood, which begs the question brought up in last week's presidential debate. Should government pull the plug on PBS and its educational programming? Don Tagala, nag-uulat.
After watching the controversial documentary called Give Up Tomorrow, shown on the Public Broadcasting System channel last Sunday, these Filipinos were moved to action to find out what they can do to help Paco Larrañaga, who is currently languishing in jail in Spain for a crime he claims he did not commit. He was only 19 years old when he was convicted of the murder of the Chong sisters in Cebu back in 1997. The documentary gave viewers not only a glimpse of the Philippine judicial process back then, but it also made viewers wonder, what if Paco Larrañaga was innocent?
Last week, the entire week, public television in the United States showed this documentary of Paco Larrañaga, Give Up Tomorrow. And after seeing it, so many of us are just at arms that innocent man, and not only him, 7 innocent young men were imprisoned, now 15 years, for a crime that they did not commit.
It would take a lot of patience, clemency from the president, and if not, perhaps a new trial, reopen the trial, and a new task force. It would also put the Philippines in the right direction in terms of what is justice and what is rule of law.
It took PBS to get these Filipinos into action. It played a big role in their new advocacy. Joe Ramos has been tuning into PBS for 30 years now, and he even contributes monetary donations annually to keep the public TV station alive.
If not for PBS, this documentary would not have been seen by the public. I hope, should Romney win, he's going to continue with the PBS and support it.
PBS is home to many educational shows like Sesame Street, but it's also home to POV, the longest-running showcase for independent films that put a human face on contemporary issues around the world. Give Up Tomorrow is not the first Filipino documentary aired on POV, and POV is seen by over 97% of the American viewing public.
POV, for one, has been well known for giving voice to otherwise non-mainstream voices, you know. Previously, it showed the film The Learning by Filipino-American Ramona Diaz about the plight of Filipino teachers hired in Baltimore, Maryland. And that was very revealing.
Simply because PBS, you know, does not bring too much money, you know, for big business. But there is something PBS is doing that no big business is doing. What is that? Reach out in a very, very benign way to other people outside America through its, you know, show.
Now available on the PBS website, the group is hoping that the more people watch the documentary Give Up Tomorrow, the more support Paco Larrañaga would get to advocate for his freedom. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.